What's up, guys? Just figured I was gonna make a quick video about installing some extra clearance lights on the side of my new trailer, because I kind of did a little searching around. I didn't find a lot of interesting things, and I'm like, I can't be the only guy out there that likes the lights, so there's gotta be somebody else looking to see how this is done. So the style of light that I have is this little single LED 3/4 inch diode, or 3/4 inch grommet sealed LED, I don't know what to call it. They're pretty cheap, a couple bucks a piece. So what you do is you drill a 3/4 inch hole, and then what I do just for a little added security is I smear the inside of the hole with just a little bit of silicone when I set the grommet, just so I have, so the silicone will bubble out around this outside edge, and then I can wipe it clean. The grommet's supposed to be weatherproof, but it's just a little added security for me. So anyway, what I got going is I started with a small bit. I think it was probably, like an eighth of an inch or so. And my trailer has this aluminum trim at the top, and then it's got steel on the inside. So what I did was I used the small bit, and I piloted my holes in. So I went through the aluminum where I wanted the light to be centered, and then I went through the steel, and then through the steel on the other side because it's boxed. Then I came back, and this one is a 15/64, and I sent that one through here next. And that is big enough that the wire will slide through. And then what I did was I have a... I have a 3/4 inch hole dozer, and I punched through the outside aluminum and then one layer of steel. And then once that's all done, I set the LED in some silicone and I stick the wire through to the inside. So I'm going to go ahead and drill my last two holes quick, and then I'm going to jump on the inside. Well, I'll show you how these little buttons click in there, and I'll jump on the inside of the trailer, and I'll show you what we're going to do to wire them up, and then I'll show you just a quick shot of the finished product. So, but yeah, anyway, you can add these pretty much anywhere you want. I'm adding, my trailer's 16 feet long. There's like 15 feet between the front light and the back light, and then I did 3 feet on center going down the trailer. So it looks really nice at night. I wired the other side last night and it looks killer. So I'm gonna get this side wired up today, and then I'll get a picture of it quick and we'll show you what it's all about. So I'll see you in the next step. So like I was saying, I just smear a little bit of silicone around the outside. Let's see if I can do this one-handed. This is going to get a little bit tricky here. So then, I don't know if you can see or not. Probably not. It's too dark in there. But there's a hole, that 15/64 hole in the back. So I do that, and then I get this grommet ready, and then I get the light ready, and then you push in. That gets kind of tough there, and once she's all the way in, there she goes, and then pretty much right there, she's good to go. So now what I'll do is I'll just, oh, just stuck my hand right under a bunch of silicone. That's sweet. Let's grab the right towel this time. So then I just take this and I just do a little wipe action there. Gosh, I am just, this is really difficult to do with one hand. Wow. Guess I'm gonna have to go wash the trailer now. Jeez. Yeah, so anyway, then I just wipe up my silicone around the outside and bingo, that's one light. So now we'll jump down and I'll show you kind of what we got going on for wiring on this. It's warm in here. It's what do you get for buying a black trailer on a 100 degree day? Got a little box fan running, hopefully it's not too loud. So I'm gonna jump over to the other side of the trailer now. So this one was a factory light. It's hard to see because the wire is black, but you can see where the green wire is. So these ones ground through the frame. So that's how that's done. So what I did is, this is my first button light. And what I did was I installed a ground, and then I chased, this is my positive wire here, or my two wire coming in. So I have the white wire set up as my ground, and I have the black wire set up as my power. So then you can see there's a light there, there's a light here, there's a light here, there's a light here, and then there's the factory light back in the corner. So there's already a wire chased along this top for the running lights. It's a green wire in my case. I don't know what it is in your case, so don't tap into it. But there's a green wire that's chased. You can see it over here. This is the same green wire on this side that runs the whole trailer. So what I'll do is I'll just splice into that, and then right here is my new button light that I just put in. So I'll splice into that. Like I said, the white is for your ground, and then in my case I'm using the black as power. So then what I do is I use, I don't have any out here right now, but I use weatherproof butt connectors. And then what I'll do is I'll make sure I chase all my wires, I'll butt connect everything together, and then I'll heat shrink them down with a lighter. I just really like knowing that they're really good and sealed. I don't want to have to worry about having wire issues in a brand new trailer down the road. So I'm going to flip the camera around, and I'll show you a glimpse of the finished side of the trailer so I can wrap this video up and then get back to work. Oh, it's good and dark now. You could barely see earlier with the lights. I made it and I didn't like it. So I'm going to set my camera up on the tripod quick, and then I'm going to jump in the truck and I throw it in reverse with the lights on so you can see how awesome the reverse lights are on it. And then I'm going to pick the camera off the tripod, and I'll do a walk around showing all the extra lights that I put in. I think this will work better than how I had it set up before. It just, you couldn't even see the lights during the day. So we'll give her a go. Okay, I'm going to start at the back of the trailer now and do our walk around. Like you saw, we had this light and this light are brakes and turn combos. We got three marker lights at the top, and then we had the two LED bright white backup lights. Feel kind of shorted. That's one incandescent bulb. I'll probably have to switch that out to an LED because I don't know if I can live with that. And then I'm not going to show you the awesomeness. I'm gonna walk up to the front over here first. So that's with the extra couple of lights. I'd like to get a couple more down here so that basically they're stacked vertically. What I'd like is as you can see, that's kind of hard to tell, there's a street light in the background. Let's get rid of that. So as you can see, this light on the fender and this light up top are stacked, and I can squeeze between those two lights. I can go front and back of the fenders, and then I'm going to basically match the top rail to the bottom rail. It should look really nice. So that's that side. And then, oh, there's a pothole there. So it's going down. Then I'm going to flip around to this side, which is basically the same thing. La-di-da. And I'll do the same thing. I'll do a light down in the bottom corner underneath the door in front and behind the wheel well, and then at the very back. But overall, it's going to look pretty sharp going down the road. I'm going to get some up on the V-nose too. I think I'm going to drop probably a button at the corner and a button at the V, just to make it look good. So, but that's it. That's a wrap on how to install some extra clearance lights to your trailer. And now I don't know why the entire neighborhood is barking, but that's really annoying. So I'm going to call her a night and shut everything down. So thanks for watching. Take her easy.